This video is made possible by Skillshare. Take any of their 20,000 classes for free for 2 months by clicking the link in the description. So I've made several videos already on both tsunamis and natural disasters that have already happened, but I've never made a video about a natural disaster that hasn't happened yet. Tsunamis, as I'm sure you know, are some of the most devastating forces in nature. But every now and then, nature likes to take something that's already scary and multiplies it. This is where the rare events called megatsunamis come in, and there's one in the future that some scientists are predicting will happen eventually. The generation of megatsunamis may be most important to understand in the Atlantic, mostly because of the large number of active oceanic volcanic islands and the fact that some of these volcanoes are showing early signs of instability. The most infamous of these is located here in the Canary Islands off the coast of West Africa, the Cumbre Vieja volcano on the island of La Palma. It's erupted several times in the past, most recently in 1949 and again in 1971, but a paper written later in 1999 by a geologist named Simon Day was the first to notice that something seemed strange. It appeared to him that the western flank of the volcano was beginning to become unstable and was in the initial stages of a collapse. Several future papers written about it hypothesized that with each future eruption, this flank would become even more unstable until at some uncertain point in the future, an eruption would be big enough to cause the entire chunk to come crashing down into the ocean. How big of a chunk would this be? Well, a paper written back in 2005 estimates that it would be between 150 and 500 cubic kilometers worth of rock, which is a lot. In the worst case scenario of 500 cubic kilometers, it would slam into the ocean and create an initial water dome of 900 meters tall, which is taller than the Burj Khalifa is in Dubai. That would be an incredible sight to see alone, but then according to this paper, the really bad stuff happens next. The dome would quickly transform into a wave about 600 meters high and surge westwards at speeds up to 720 kilometers per hour, about the same speed as a jet aircraft. Several hundred meter high Titanic tsunamis will crash on the western shores of the Canary Islands, and shortly after, smaller 50 to 100 meter high waves will impact the African west coast. Meanwhile, a solid wave 500 kilometers across surges westwards across the Atlantic towards America. Since the Canary Islands acted like the Jupiter for Europe and took most of the tsunami's blow in that direction, small waves between 5 and 7 meters will impact the shores of Spain and England and cause only minor damage. Finally, after traveling for about 9 hours, the first part of the wave makes impact in the Americas. After traveling for so long, the tsunami will have lost most of its size. But even still, 10 meter high waves will hit the coast of Newfoundland and Canada, while larger 15 to 20 meter high waves impact the northern coast of South America from Brazil to Venezuela. Unfortunately for Florida, though, they will end up taking the brunt of the tsunami's power here. 20 to 25 meter high waves will crash across the east coast of the state and severely damage cities like Miami and Jacksonville. The waves here will be about the same size as the waves of the 2004 Indian Ocean tsunami in Indonesia, and similar sized 10 to 25 meter high waves will crash across the rest of the US East Coast, which would definitely damage cities like Charleston, New York, and Boston. While all of that sounds pretty horrible, it's very important to take all of this with a grain of salt. This is a worst-case scenario based on a scientific paper that itself has received a pretty fair amount of criticism from other scientists for sounding too alarmist. Megatsunamis generated from a volcanic collapse like this appear to be common on a geological timescale, as there is evidence to show that it's happened dozens of times in the Atlantic alone over the past million years, but that's still incredibly uncommon on a human timescale. The only time in recorded human history that a similar event to this has happened so far was in 1888 on Ritter Island in Papua New Guinea, when a volcano erupted and caused a 5 cubic kilometer chunk of rock to collapse into the ocean. This did cause a relatively large tsunami, 15 meters high, that damaged the surrounding islands, but it was hardly the gigantic size that could happen in the Cumbre Vieja scenario. Further, the scenario that I just described is the worst case scenario. It's possible that if the western flank of the island does collapse, it would be significantly less mass, which would create a significantly smaller tsunami that may not be even capable of crossing the Atlantic. Even if the worst case scenario does happen, it probably won't happen at any point in any of our lifetimes. It will probably happen several thousand years from now when the eruptions cause the flank to grow even weaker. So realistically, you shouldn't have to worry about this ever happening. Although it probably probably will happen at some point in the future, that's a problem that future humans will have hopefully figured out by then. In the meantime, the only reason you should ever worry about it is if a supervillain sets a residence on the island and decides to artificially turn it into an island version of the Death Star. If you are an aspiring supervillain watching this video though, you'll need a lot of certain skills to be able to pull anything off, and there's no better place to learn those skills than by going to Skillshare next. Well, actually, you probably shouldn't become a supervillain because that's bad, but take that motivation and learn something productive instead from the over 20,000 classes that are offered at Skillshare. You can learn stuff from experts like HTML, photography, or even how to animate your own YouTube videos from the largest YouTube channel in Germany, Kurzgesagt. I'm taking their course to continue learning animation tricks, and you can do that yourself with anything on the site that you may be interested in. They have classes on pretty much anything you can imagine that you can use to start just about any business or hobby, except maybe being an evil supervillain, but best of all, you can try out all of these classes for free for 2 entire months when you sign up using the link in the description at https://skl.sh/reallifelore13.